Period blood is a very strong taboo in many cultures. Therefore, I think not everyone has directly seen period blood. So today with this video, I would like to change this a little bit. We're going to look at period blood directly and see what it is under the microscope. Then, we're also going to see how period blood is different from normal blood. In order to make this possible, I asked a favor to a very good friend of mine who wants to remain anonymous. But we got a very good and fresh sample. Welcome to the Microverse. Are you ready for some surprises? It is also my first time to see period blood under a microscope. At first glance, period blood just looks like normal blood. We have a lot of healthy red blood cells here. Red blood cells are these flowing discs. They transport usually oxygen. But hold on, what is this? What are these translucent things here? It turns out they are mucosa cells from the inside of the uterus. These cells are similar to the mucosa cells found in our mouths. You can touch them right now with your tongue on the inside of your cheek if you want. The uterus is lined with a spongy layer made from these cells. Every month, this layer is removed and renewed in case there is no pregnancy. Okay, interesting, but I started to wonder, where are the white blood cells? What are these mysterious blobs here? These individual dots almost look a little bit like white blood cells. White blood cells usually tend to move very slow, so to test my hypothesis, I sped up the footage to see if there is any movement. And oh boy, wow! How cool is that? These white blood cells are macrophages on an absolute feeding frenzy. Like a crazy pack of hungry wolves absolutely eviscerating their prey. Their prey, in this case, are the mucosa cells from the uterus. Just right now, we are witnessing the human body eating itself. But watch this. These macrophages seem to be extremely selective in which cells they attack. Here you can see a cluster of mucosa cells. The macrophages only swarm to the cell in the center and leave the others completely untouched. The destruction is merciless, but extremely selective. During the period, a rallying call is sent throughout the body. The macrophages start to gather in the uterus and begin to eat the cell lining of the uterus, the endometrium. The female body literally self-inflicts a massive wound every month that will heal very quickly without leaving any scars or lasting damages. The uterus is an organ with outstanding self-healing capacities. It is a real phoenix from the ashes. The macrophages not only destroy, but play also an important role in the reconstruction of this endometrium cell layer. Let's appreciate a moment their hard work. Enough macrophage porn for today. Now let's compare period blood to normal blood. At first glance, we can say there are no mucosa cells in here. Good. Also, the white blood cells are spread out throughout the liquid and don't bunch up. What other differences can we find? Very importantly, normal blood contains fibrins responsible for blood clotting. These fibers form when blood comes into contact with air and help to close the wound. They are like a nano band-aid. In period blood, these fibrins have been deactivated, making it more runny, allowing the period blood to escape the body more easily. In conclusion, period blood is real blood that cannot clot normally, contains mucosa cells from the uterus, and a massive swarm of hyperaggressive macrophages that not only destroy, but also heal. Lastly, let's see how period blood changes throughout the period. The period blood we have seen so far was from the beginning of the period. Now look at this. This is from the fourth day of the period and you can see dramatic changes. The red blood cells don't look very healthy anymore. Their shape changed and their color has faded. The macrophages have deactivated and started to form these heaps of dead organic matter. A massive change within a short window of time. So here is what we have learned. There is absolutely nothing to fear about period blood. On the contrary, it is absolutely fascinating and beautiful. There is a lot to learn here about the role and the behavior of macrophages and about the amazing self-healing capacities of the uterus. We have barely scratched the surface. Please subscribe and join me in the next video. Thank you so much for watching. Bye-bye.